Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. That means he has empowered me.
Someone says, taking your inheritance by force, verse 2. We had part 1 last week, Sunday. Taking your inheritance by force. And we read several scriptures that shows that our inheritance can be taken by force. And we found a lot of examples in the scriptures. We saw the 5 daughters of Zelophehad, the man who died in the wilderness, and his 5 daughters were left behind, no mother, no father. And because the father has no son, they took their name from the family list. They took it out and no inheritance for them. And these 5 ladies sat down. They begin to think and say, if we begin to live like this, our father's name will be wiped out from the tribe of Joseph. And we will live without inheritance. The Bible says, they step out with violent things and approach the inapproachable. They came to the place where women are not supposed to go. The Bible says, they went there. And they present themselves before Moses, the high priest, and all the general assemblies and all the elders of the 12 tribes of Israel. And they brought their case forth and they demanded that justice should take place. They were violent in the spirit. They were not ready to spare anything from these elders. And the Bible says, Moses inquired from the Lord. And when Moses inquired from the Lord, and the Lord told Moses, the daughters of Zelophehad arise, change the constitution, give them their father property. These 5 ladies broke record in the scripture. That is why their names are mentioned in the scriptures. And they turned the constitution in favor of any man who had no son when he died. Therefore, his inheritance is being passed to the daughters. Even up today, women face such humiliation. Even up to today, there are families who will deprive ladies from having a full right to their father property because they are not male children. But we saw it in the Bible that God did not neglect them. So these ladies stepped out with violent faith and they took their possession by force. That is what we are going to do today. It doesn't matter how long we have been facing that challenge. We are going to pray violently today and take back our inheritance. I told you on Sunday, God will give you something. The devil will not allow you to take it. The devil will always come with obstacles, barriers, so that you will be frustrated and you will give up. While God is watching you, the important thing is that God has given you the authority and power to take it because it belongs to you. That's why he told Jeremiah, Jeremiah 14:12, he said, I will deal with those who tamper with the inheritance of my people. God gave them that inheritance. But some people snatched it away from them until they cried to the Lord. Just like the daughter of Zelophehad, we are going to cry to the Lord today. My marriage, my job, my document, my husband, my wife, my children is coming to me. I'm taking them back by force. We read the scriptures in Matthew 11:12. He said, until the day of John the Baptist, that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. And he said, only the violence took it by what? By force. I explained to you the Greek word that was used for violence. It's called piazo, which means destruction, harms, oppression, intimidation, affliction. In other words, the kingdom of God suffered afflictions. The kingdom of God suffered humiliation, intimidation, oppression, and afflictions. But Jesus used a strong comment and said, only the violent. The violent is a person. The Greek word is biastis, which means a strong and forceful person who is eager to go through and break through by force, irregardless of any obstacles. So Jesus said, the violent is that man, that strong man, that strong woman, who will not give up. No matter how many times he or she has tried, he will keep on pushing and pushing and pushing until there is a breakthrough. That's the violent man and woman. Jesus said in Matthew 23, verse 13, he said, woe unto those scribes and Pharisees. He said, you hypocrites. He said, you lock up the doors of heaven. You yourself will not enter. You will not allow another man to enter. And Jesus makes a statement again. In Luke 16, verse 16, he said, up to now, the kingdom of God has been preached. He said, but only those who are violent are pressing to enter through it. What Jesus is trying to say, there are people who are preventing others not to enter. But Jesus said, many are pressing. What is pressing? Force. They force themselves into it. They force themselves to take it. That's why God has promised us some certain things in life. Listen to it. Most of those things will not come to you easily. Hello. The devil cannot fold his hands and watch you heriting that blessing. The devil is not asleep. God asked him in the book of Job, chapter 1, he said, where are you coming from? He said, I walk to and fro in the earth. That tells you he has no other job to monitor people. Peter said, the devil roars like he moves and go forth like a roaring lion, seeking for whom to devour. He's not at rest. He will never sleep. Proverbs 4 says, they never sleep, not slumber, until they make somebody fall. It is Christian that is sleeping. It is we that cannot wake up and pray. It is we who cannot come to all night. Witches don't sleep. They present in the coffin every day. As long as there is night, they will be here. So what am I trying to say? That inheritance, that blessing can just come easily like that. You have to press, as Jesus said. There are some easy blessings that can come, except that we just arrive to God. But there are strong blessings that will open doors, not only for you, but for your generation. Satan will fight it. When he knows that when you have this particular thing, people will be saved. Then he will stand and block it. That's what Jesus is talking about. Taking by force.
The Bible talks about Hannah. Hannah has been going to church, praying, seeking for the fruit of the womb. But the time came when he said, "Today, I'm going to take it by force." That is when he challenged God. I told God, "If you will give me a male child, I will turn that child back to you." In other words, God, if you can do it, me, I will do it. God tried. God said, "I will try." And God did it. And she fulfilled her vow. That's violent faith. She challenged God. As daughters of Zephaniah, they were not afraid to come to the tabernacles of holiness. The school of the tabernacle, where the elders meet for judgment and present their case. We are going to present our case before God. No matter how long it is, God is going to hear our prayer. Micah chapter 2. The book of Micah chapter 2. I don't want you to be discouraged. God Almighty, who has been with us for years, will never forsake us. He will never forsake us. Micah chapter 2. Micah after Jonah, after the book of Jonah. I want to read from verse 1 to 3. I want to see the nature of people who can seize people's inheritance. So that is why you need to take it by force this afternoon. If you are there, say amen. He said, "What of those who devise iniquity and work out evil on their beds? At morning light they practice it, because it is in their power. Because it is in their power on their heads, and they confess speed and take them by violence." He said, "Woe unto people who in their bed they meditate on how to do evil in the morning time." The Bible said, when they woke up, they practice the evil because it is in their hands to do it. They have the power. He said, they convey people's feet. They seize people's land by violence. That's what Jesus Christ says. The kingdom of God suffered for violence. This is what took the feet, the property of people with violence. There are many of you who are supposed to have married by now, who are supposed to have job by now, or document by now. But there are personalities that will say, "You will not have it, you will not marry." Or the government can say, "You don't qualify, we can't give it to you." Even if it's in their constitution, we'll give it to you. So they convey the seed and the land of the people with violence. So they convey seed and take them by violence. Also houses, they seize them. So they oppress a man and his house, and a man and his inheritance. These are wicked personalities. He said, "Therefore, God says the Lord, behold, I'm against your family. I'm devising disaster from which you cannot remove your neck, nor shall you walk humbly. For this is an evil time." My God will answer them today. Amen. God said he will devise destruction for them, so that you can take back your inheritance. So that you can hold it back again. But you're not going to fold your hands. That's why you're going to cry out like those five sisters and take back your inheritance. Mark chapter 10. Mark chapter 10. If you are there, we're going to read from verse 46. There is a man in this particular portion of the scripture who took back his inheritance, his blessing with force. Mark chapter 10 from verse 46. If you are there, you say amen again. He said, now they came to Jericho. As he went out of Jericho with his disciples, a great multitude. And blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the road begging. Mark 10, verse 46. 47. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Then many wanted him to be quiet. There are people who don't want your life to shine. This man asked, who is coming? Why is there noise? They said, Jesus of Nazareth is passing. And the Bible said, when Jesus came close, he shouted, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. They said, quiet! You are a blind man. Quiet! You are an immigrant. You cannot inherit this inheritance. Quiet! You don't come from this family, you can't get it. Quiet! You are not righteous enough, you can't get these blessings. There are some satanic voices. Sometimes those voices even come from your heart. The voices come from your heart and tell you, my family has never risen to this greatness. Why am I thinking like this? I can't get it. These are like the voices that try to silence blind Bartimaeus. But look at what violent man with violent faith can do. He said, there are many who want him to be quiet, but he cried out all the more. Bartimaeus, quiet! Jesus! Quiet! Jesus! The more they shut him down, the more he shouted more. How many times have you received disappointment and you never shout again? How many times have you been disappointed and you quit? They shut your voice once, you never speak again. Or they reject your application, you never apply again. But you plan to quit. That is the time you have to shout more. A violent man, not quiet. A violent woman, not quiet. The Bible describes them as strong men and women who go through wars, who break through walls by force. They shouted on him, quiet, blind man. People who can see are not able to reach him. You are calling him. But the Bible said, the more they tried to shut him, the more he cried out. The more he cried out. If he has accepted that rejection by the multitude that told him to be quiet, he would have been a blind man till now. His story wouldn't have been in the Bible. Because there are many people in the days of Jesus who were not healed. Jesus said it. There are many lepers, there are many blind men who even know that Jesus heals, and they never heal. But this man, he took his sanitary before us. He said, there are many want him to be quiet, he cried all out the more, son of David, have mercy. So Jesus stood and commanded him to be called. My God will call you this afternoon. Yeah. Heaven will hear your voice. My God will send an angel to minister to you this afternoon. My God will send an angel to minister to you this afternoon. Every area of your need, you shall be ministered to. Every area of your heart desire, you shall be ministered to. In the name of Jesus. Jesus sent for him. Jesus sent for him. He said, Jesus stood and commanded him to be called. Then they called him. The blind man saying to him, be of good cheer, arise. He's calling you. And throwing aside his garment, he rose and came to Jesus. So Jesus answered and said to him, what do you want me to do for you? And the blind man said to him, Rabbi, that teacher, that I may receive my sight. And Jesus said to him, go, your faith has made you well. And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus on the road. That's boundless faith. That's what God is looking for. Not a sleeping faith. A faith that keeps knocking. Not a faith that knocks once and get tired. Violent man and woman, he's the one who keeps pushing no matter the years. They have it in his mind or in our mind that one day I'm breaking through. That's the violent man. It's not the one people will shut up once and never rise again. The scripture said, righteous man will fall seven times, but seven times will he rise again. We don't fall to remain where we are. We fought to rise to our feet. And this man took back his sight. The man that was blind. He took it by force. The people asked him to shout. But he kept on asking. He kept on pushing. He kept on pressing. Until his inheritance came to him. Genesis chapter 32. Somebody will receive back his inheritance to him. The promises of God in your life will be fulfilled today. Yeah. Somebody is going home with blessing today. Yeah. Somebody is going home with his inheritance today. Yeah. Your portion shall be given back to you today. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Genesis 32. There is another man that I expected in this portion of the scripture. We know him very well, our father Jacob. His life was in a mess. Oh, he needed a change. And that change has to cost him something. Listen to me. For you to break through in life, there are something that you have to give out. But what you will give out cannot be compared to the glory of what you are looking for. There's something that you will lose. But be ready to lose that thing. Be ready to lose that thing, because when you lose it, there's going to be greatness. When you lose it, God is going to supply you what you are pursuing. Now Genesis 32 from 22. If you are there, you say amen. 32 verse 22. He said, and he arose that night, that's Jacob, and took his two wives, his two female servants, and his 11 sons, and crossed over to the fold of Jabbok. He took them, sent them over to the brook, and sent over what he had. Then Jacob was left alone. And a man wrestled with him until the breaking of the day. Now listen to this before we continue. Jacob just fled from his father's in-law, Laban. And this man was after him, pursuing him, because the man was angry that he left without allowing him to say goodbye to his children, grandchildren, and daughter. And finally he caught up with him. And God helped Jacob, and the issue was settled. Now Jacob is about to go back to his father's land. He needs to see Isaac before Isaac died. Now, he can't go because his brother Esau has vowed that I will kill you because he stole his brother's blessing. Now it's about 20 years ago. And he's going, he's afraid. And he sends message ahead of him. They brought gifts to Esau. And they told him, Jacob, your brother Esau has come with 400 men to come and see you. And Jacob was afraid. Because remember the last word Esau told him, I will kill you. That's why he ran away from home. And he was afraid. He was frustrated. In his life, he just finished experiencing humiliation. He suffered intimidation in his father's in-law house. Laban cheated him several times. Now, because of that, he ran away from that place to go back to his family's house, and there is
a barrier in the way.
The Bible says he put out his family. It has to come in your life that you have to separate some certainties. Put aside some companions, some friends. Put aside that phone, that Facebook, that Twitter, that WhatsApp. Put them aside. Off that TV, off that radio. Put some certainties aside and sit alone. If you do that, you will wrestle with the Lord. Hello? That's what he did. He put aside everything. He separated his wife, his children, his servant, and all he had. He said, just go. Let me stay beside him. Esau is going to kill me. Let Esau kill me. I will say, he stood alone that night, and God appeared to him. God needs to appear to him so that he can break through Esau. Now, verse 23. He took them and sent them over the brook and sent over all he had. Then Jacob was left alone, and the man wrestled with him until the breaking of the day. Now when he saw that he didn't prevail against him, he touched the socket of his hip, and the socket of Jacob, his was out of joint, as he wrestled with the man. And he said, let me go, for the day breaks. But he said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. This man that was wrestling with Jacob, this is an angelic being. Now, he knew that when they break, it's not going to be good for people to see him, because this is not human. He begged Jacob, please, the day is about to break, let me go. Jacob heard him. He said, I won't let you go. During the time of the wrestling, the Bible says he touched Jacob's hips. And Jacob's hips was dislocated. That's why Jacob's leg is broken now. He's still wrestling. With one leg, he's still wrestling. Till now, that leg was like that. He lost it for the blessing. He was still wrestling, holding the man. I won't let you go until you bless me. You have to bargain. And that will bless me, or I hold you people see you when they break. This violence means. So only the violence taking back from us. So right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. Only those who are forceful, who don't get tired in pushing and pressing. He said they take it by what? By force. Jacob took it by force. And when the man saw that he couldn't prevail against him, he knew, if I don't bless this man will hold me here. Look at what the Bible said. Verse 25 again said, now when he saw that he didn't prevail against him, he tore the socket of his hip. And the socket of his hips was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaks. But he said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. So he said to him, what is your name? He said, Jacob. And he said, your name shall no longer call Jacob but Israel. Your name today is favor. Yeah. Your name today is success. Yeah. Your name today is testimony. Yeah. Your name today is goodness. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. And change his name. But do not change the blessing will come to him. So he said that your name shall be called, not that called Jacob. And said, your name shall no longer call Jacob but Israel, for you have struggled with God and with man, and you have prevailed. Then Jacob said, ask me, tell me your name. I pray. And he said, why is it that you ask my name? And he blessed him dear. He blessed him dear. God is blessing somebody here. As we wrestle today, I said, God is blessing somebody here. God is blessing you here. God is blessing your spirit around here. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says God bless him there. God turned the situation around. Turned the situation around. Everything become blessings. Jacob's life changed from that day on. And after that, and he came across Esau. Esau that has been charging that I will kill Jacob. The Bible said when Esau saw Jacob, Esau ran to him. They held each other and wept and greeted each other. He has wrestled with a man. Are you hearing me? So doors is open. He brought gifts for Esau. Esau said, I don't need your gift. I have enough. Just go and settle with your family. All the wrecking for 20 years was abolished. Esau never touched him again. Because last night, he wrestled with a man. And that man is not an ordinary man. He blessed him. Those who have not been cooperating with you, after this afternoon, they will complain for your favor. They will pronounce for your favor. They will gather for your favor. In the name of Jesus Christ. One more scripture before we pray. One more scripture. Genesis, Matthew 15. Matthew chapter 15. Matthew 15. I love one woman again who took it by force. She took the blessings by force. Matthew 15. We're going to read from verse 21. If you are there, say amen. He said, then Jesus went out from there and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Cana came from that region and cried to him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed. But Jesus answered him not a word. This is rejection. We call this today in a slow word negative. He never answered her a word. She began to cry along with the disciples of Jesus. Jesus, I know you can do it. Have mercy on me. My daughter is possessed. What a radical thing. The daughter is not even there. She believed if the master can answer her, her daughter will be healed. The Bible said Jesus didn't answer her. Don't give up. Hello? Don't give up. Christianity is a continuity of pressing forward. Are you hearing me? It's what rather than Christianity is a continuity of pressing forward. We don't stop on the way. We are not those who break down on the way. We keep on pushing until we see the light. Until we see the light. Verse 23, but he answered her not a word. And these disciples came and urged him, saying, send her away, for she cries after us. This woman crying after them. And the disciples begin to beg Jesus, if you will not answer this woman, tell her to go. Tell her to go. Wherever we go, she's following us. Jesus, he kept her quiet. Jesus wants to see the violence in her. He wants to see how radical is her faith. Because what she's asking for is not yet her time. Because she's a Gentile. She's asking for the food of Jacob's children, which is not yet to pass to the Gentiles. Jesus knew in his heart, if this woman can take it by force, let her take it. That's why it's not her time. If she can take it, let her take it. The Bible says she began to cry after Jesus. And the disciples begged Jesus, oh God, send her away. Verse 24, but Jesus answered and said, I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. This is another rejection. This is enough for the woman to just come back. But she had, he has answered the woman and said, see, I was not sent to you. So you can have what you are looking for. But the woman never gave up. Say, I will never give up. Even if it delays. Say, even if it delays, I will never give up. I'm taking back my inheritance today. Amen. He said, there was no signs except in the lordship of the house of Israel. Then she came and worshipped him. Every move Jesus made, she made another move. He said, I'm not sent to you. I know. The Bible says she came on that feet and began to worship him. Jesus couldn't stand that. Jesus has to tell her another truth. So that she will understand that what she's asking for is not for her. But this woman is ready to take it by force. She's a violent woman. Violent woman taking it by force. Verse 25. Then she came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But Jesus answered and said, it is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs. This is enough for her to just pack and unload and hiss. And go. Because now Jesus has told her the truth. I have the bread you are looking for. But this bread is for some particular people who are special. They are not for people like you. How many times have you been knocked down by such situation? How many times family, friends, neighbor has hit you with unexpected situations that make you feel that the whole world is on you? How many times have you been frustrated over something you are looking for dearly? She begged for the healing of her daughter. But the person who has it is telling her something negative. This is enough for her to quit. It's enough. This woman's story is teaching us a lesson that Christ said has to be soldier, violent soldier, in that life of the rejection and the denial. No matter how strong is the situation, no matter how tough it is, if you can press and push as this woman, if you can continue to push, by force you will take it. She took it. Look at what she said. Jesus was shocked. Verse 26. And he answered, said, it's not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs. And he said, yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord, I know. He said, yet, even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fell from the master's table. I know. Say, the food of the children is not for dogs. But it's not small what they fall from the table, dogs they eat that. Jesus tired. He didn't argue. I know the food is for the children, isn't it? What about the particles that fall from the children? Dogs eat them and they are satisfied. Give me the particles. The first! The first! And Jesus looked at her and said, what a great sex! He said, go, your daughter is healed. And she left, her daughter was healed. Your situation is solved today. God will answer you today. God will answer you today. Jesus will answer you today. Stumble the figures of other prayer. We are taking it by force. Regardless of where it is. Is it in the government office? Is it in the witchcraft cupboard? Is it in the paper corner? Wherever it is, we are taking it by force. We are taking it by force. You are going to decree. What is it that you are looking for? What is it that you are yearning for? You are crying for every day. What is it that is giving you sleepless night? What is it that you have been thinking and you cannot tell people? It is time for you to take it. It is time for you to take it. Begin to decree. Say today, I'm taking my inheritance. Lift up the voice and begin to decree. Today I'm taking my inheritance. I am taking it right now. The door and your opportunity. The door and your opportunity is open for me. I am taking it. I am taking it. I am taking it today. I am taking it today. I am taking it today. It is my time to take it back. I am taking back my marriage, my business, my work, my husband, my children. I am taking it. No matter what. I'm not tired. I am taking it. I am taking it back. I am taking it back. For now, my government is released. My marriage is released. My wife is released. My husband is released. My job is released. My business is released. I'm taking my professor. These are the bells I'm going to come out.
Jesus, never pray.